Good afternoon to all. This is Kokai from the Philippines, and I hope you hear me clearly. So my sharing would be on the sustainability and scalability on legal empowerment initiatives experience in the Philippines. So this initiative we call this as community paralegality for the barefoot lawyer. This is empowering the grassroots communities, the indigenous people, upland and rural farmers on legal aspects as part of asserting their rights to their land, to their ancestral territories, to their lives and livelihoods. The creation of the CPLT or the Community Paralegality, Barefoot Lawyer, had a very positive effect on the assertion of community rights, strengthening the community advocacy and deepening the ownership and understanding by the communities on their legal cases. This likewise has positive effect on governance as it creates an enabling environment for communities to assert their rights through governmental institutions and mechanisms that capture and address process citizens' grievances. I just go through. These are the two case community cases, Subanen in Mindanao, and Anislagan. Anislagan is a community farmer or rural farmer, and Subanen tribe are indigenous peoples in Mindanao. This community paralegal team are just training organizing, just training on affidavit gathering, assisting the lawyers, interview, court visits, gather documents, training the women and youth, documentation, and so on, including campaign planning, including creating press releases, and other tasks as a paralegal, meaning they will assist the lawyers other than doing legal work that can be done by the community or the community members themselves. So the overall result of this community paralegal team, deepening the ownership, meaning deepening the ownership of the community in designing the legal strategies, ownership in terms of crafting their own strategies and understanding by the communities of their own legal cases. Not only the type of the lawyers, but even the community themselves understand their legal cases. This has a positive effect on the assertion of community rights in strengthening their community advocacy. The CPLT legal program and its work enable the community to avert their positive displacement of their families. Legal cases become an arena not only for lawyers, but tools which the community understood, supported, and owned. The legal intervention became an opportunity for participation and capacity building. The community paralegal team were able to provide help in fact-finding missions concerning violence and illegal demolition, since the CPLT or the barefoot lawyers are more familiar with the local landscape, the local dialect, so they are helpful in conducting the fact-finding mission. They collated data, conducted interviews, served as translators to local people, to media, to international visitors, and other support groups. They provided follow-up interviews, data gathering for report submissions to government agencies. For sustainability and stability, the second liners, like the youth, the men and women, were trained by the pioneers, since most of the case studies that I shared are stories and strategies, legal intervention of the communities who've been struggling to defend their rights in the last 20 years. In the case of the Subanen tribe, that's already more than 20 years. And in the case of Anislagan, I showed you earlier, already more than 10 years. So they trained the second liners, the women, men, and the youth, in order to continue the assertion of the rights in defending their land. Second one is mentoring, coaching by the pioneers of the paralegal work. The third one is hands-on and actual exposures to meetings. So handling meeting with the government agencies, visiting government agencies and request files, media hopping like radio visits to be a good speaker. The fourth one is attendance invitation by non-government organizations on policy briefing, roundtable discussion on new laws and policy cases, so that they will be updated with new policy trends, new threats to their issues and other dynamics. So from time to time they attend and they are invited to forums or policy briefings from support groups. Sustainability also some of the communities, nearby communities, were inspired by the initiative of that community, so they replicated. So that would that would expand in terms of resource defense of the community. Another one is skills enhancement from support groups. While they have already trained by the local paraligas, but they also accepted the invitation from other support groups to enhance the existing skills in terms of campaigns, legal research, handling campaigns, or conducting media and media activities. And the last one that I wrote is developing local and community friendly paralegal modules. So in order to sustain their initiatives and their good practices, so they come up a module in order for their second liners or third liners to help in to sustain their initiatives. So that's all from the Philippines experience.